Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of our commander, Colonel Andrew Esch, and his command sergeant major, Dan Smith, welcome to our program today here at Brucker Hall. Thank you. We are the United States Army Blues, and our mission since 1972 has been to provide musical support to the National Capital Region and the preservation of America's art form, jazz. Today's a very special day. We pay tribute to all the men and women who served in our armed forces, and thank you for your service. Happy Veterans Day. Our program will feature jazz greats who have served in our military, and we will be able to put on their music for you today. My name is Chief Warrant Officer 2, Jaquel Smalls, and this is your United States Army Blues. Thank you. Please rise for the playing of the national anthem.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Chief Smalls. Welcome to the U.S. Army Blues celebration of jazz greats who served in the military. We thought it would be a little different than what we normally do because we were surprised at how many of our great jazz artists, legendary jazz artists through history, has served in the armed forces. I want to acknowledge that first tune that we came out on was this Magic Flea, by the great Sammy Nestico, who had a great relationship with the Count Basie Orchestra. A lot of the tunes you've heard Count Basie do are from the pen of the great Sammy Nestico. On that tune, we heard Staff Sergeant Dustin Mollick on the tenor saxophone. We also heard Staff Sergeant Jan Knutson from the Army Strings helping us out this evening on guitar. And we also heard some fabulous drum stylings of our drummer, Staff Sergeant Eric Purz. So this next chart that we're doing was made famous by the great Roy Eldridge, trumpet player. And Roy Eldridge was sort of came after Louis Armstrong and heavily influenced the trumpet players after him. Dizzy Gillespie, as a matter of fact. And Roy Eldridge played in the great Artie Shaw band. And Roy Eldridge was one of the first African-American musicians that Artie Shaw hired. And he told Roy that, you know, as long as you're in my band, we're gonna be treated the same, and you're gonna be paid very well because you're that good. And he's got his nickname, Little Jazz, from his small stature. But he was big on the trumpet. So we'd like to feature one of our not so newest members of the band anymore. He's been here about a year, right? He's been here about a year, but since then we've gotten like two or three or four more new members in the band, so it's a great thing. We're gonna feature Staff Sergeant Josh Kaufman on Artie Shaw's Little Jazz. We'll be right back. Staff Sergeant Josh Kaufman. Staff Sergeant Josh Kaufman. Yeah. Playing little jazz. We call him Junior, though, here in the band, so. Junior. So now we're going to do a favor that everyone knows, In the Mood. However, give you a little history about this mood, this tune. It was actually based off a melody from a tune called Tar Paper Stomp by a trumpeter named Wingy Malone. In the Mood was written by Joe Garland, who was a saxophonist, composer, and arranger, who did a couple of tours with the Louis Armstrong band. 1938 was the first recording of this tune by the Edgar Hayes Orchestra, the first recording under the name In the Mood. And also shortly after that, it was being played with Artie Shaw. Artie Shaw's band was playing it. But it didn't really garner too much, catch on, and it couldn't fit on the side of a 78 p.m. record because it was too long. So then Joe Garland takes a tune to Glenn Miller in around 1939 or so. So Glenn Miller edits it, shortens it a little bit, and it becomes very, very popular, and even making it into the Hall of Fame in 1983, the Grammy Hall of Fame. So on this tune, you're gonna hear, I think I might solo on this tune, and you're gonna hear our Sergeant First Class Promotable Eli Gonzalez for a little bit. And this is the Edgar Hayes version of In the Mood. So this next piece is always a fun one for the trumpet section to do. We're going to do a piece called Bugle Call Rag. And as you can see, Doc Severinsen, spending several years in the Army. This tune, Bugle Call Rag, was first recorded by the New Orleans Rhythm Kings in 1922, but they called it Bugle Call Blues. It was popularized by orchestras such as the Benny Goodman Orchestra, the Glenn Miller Orchestra, and the Duke Ellington Orchestra. This arrangement is by Bill Holman, written just specifically for Doc Severinsen, who ran the Tonight Show Band. Johnny Carson had a Tonight Show Band for over 25 years. Bugle Call Rag. Bugle Call Rag, ladies and gentlemen. Staff Sergeant Dustin Mollick on that. Master Sergeant Graham Breelove. Our lead trumpeter, Master Sergeant Mark Wood. We'd like to continue with a beautiful, slower, bluesy tune written by the great Thad Jones, who's in the Army, 1943 to 46. After he left the Army, he spent about 9 years with the Count Basie Orchestra in the trumpet section. Thad was a great trumpet player. After that, he actually co-led the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra that is still going to this day in the Village Vanguard in New York City. And then after that, he came back to the Basie Band to lead the organization. And I believe he wrote this tune for Count Basie. This is called basically yours. And we're going to hear the fabulous piano jazz stylings from Staff Sergeant James Collins. Basically yours.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Staff Sergeant James Collins on the piano. Frank Foster, tenor saxophonist, served in the 7th Infantry Division in Korea. There you go. Hua. And in 1953, he joined Count Basie's band, and he wrote a couple of notable tunes that we all know, Shiny Stockings, Blues in Hoss Flat. In 1986, Frank Foster took over the band from Thad Jones. So Frank Foster started running the Count Basie Orchestra, and he wrote this, he recorded the band on a record called The Diane Shore with Count Basie, Diane Shore with the Count Basie Orchestra, and on that record was a Diane Shore's original tune called Deedle's Blues, which won a Grammy. Also on that record were several other great charts that Diane Shore did with the Count Basie Orchestra. So here to sing that for you this evening is the enlisted group leader of the popular group Downrange. Let's give a round of applause for Sergeant Major Crystal Reams.
Drummer that you like his playing, tell the singer that you like the song. I don't know a lot about technology today, but I know how to swing it when the band begins to play. Come on baby, don't you feel like dancing when you hear Count Basie call? If you like the music, you can have it, you can have it anytime.
Sergeant Major Crystal Reams, ladies and gentlemen. Sergeant Major Crystal Reams. And she's going to be back a little later in the program. Thank you.
On November 11th, 1918, at the conclusion of World War I, Armistice Day was declared to honor all those who served in World War I. After World War II and the Korean War, Congress went on to declare Armistice Day, Veterans Day, to honor all Americans who have served in our military. Representative Dan Lipinski had this to say when he was asked about Veterans Day. He said, "On Veterans Day, let us remember the service of our veterans and let us renew our national promise to fulfill our sacred obligations to our veterans and their families who have sacrificed so much so that we all can live free." Ladies and gentlemen, in tribute and honor of all of our veterans, we'll have to play a special rendition of America the Beautiful. So we're going to continue on with our celebration today for all the veterans. We invite you, when you hear your service song, please stand to be recognized. Yesterday, if you didn't know, was the Marine Corps' birthday, so we're going to start off the service song with their song. So here we go. This is the Armed Forces Salute, starting off with the Marine Corps. United States Navy. United States Air Force. United States Coast Guard. Gentlemen, your United States Army. Again, thank you all for your service. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That was
Norwegian Wood, arranged by Bill Holman. I believe that was originally a Beatles tune, but arranged for Bill Holman and really made popular after Buddy Rich played that song. We're going to go on with a tune by the great Cannonball Adderley. Cannonball was very famous for one of the most famous jazz musicians from the 50s and 60s. Also did a notable stint in the Miles Davis Quintet. And he also studied at the U.S. Navy School of Music and led two army bands. Yeah, and his brother, Nat Adderley, you may know, he was also in the army with him. And this is a tune written by Cannonball Adderley, arranged by Oliver Nelson. And it's going to feature Master Sergeant Antonio Horta and me, Sergeant Major Kenny Rittenhouse.
Thank you.
Sergeant Antonio Orta. I'm Sergeant Major Kenny Rittenhouse. Thank you very much. So we'd like to bring back to the stage to sing a great song that was recorded by Ella Fitzgerald and the Duke Ellington Orchestra. This one we call Imagine My Frustration. And let's bring back Sergeant Major Crystal Reams. Thank you. Sergeant Major Crystal Reams, ladies and gentlemen. Sergeant Major Crystal Reams.
I want to take a minute to introduce a few of the members of the Blues that you may not have heard from this evening. Master Sergeant Promotable, Ken McGee on lead trumpet. He's been promoted in January, and he's going to be our, well, he is our blues group leader. All the work that's coming to you, man. Staff Sergeant Jake Kraft, bass trombone. Staff Sergeant Aaron Eckert. Sergeant First Class Promotable Eli Gonzalez, helping us out from the U.S. Army Ceremonial Band. Also helping us out from the Ceremonial Band is Staff Sergeant Doug O'Connor. On bass, we have Sergeant First Class Reagan Bruff. And driving the band this evening, the engine, Staff Sergeant Eric Purz.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been a wonderful audience today. We want to thank you for coming out and really being a part of this special day for our veterans. To check out our band, you can go on usarmyband.com. Again, that's usarmyband.com. And you can check out not only this group, but all the groups that make up Pershing Zone. Also, we have a Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram page. So please check us out there. Again, thank you for coming out. Happy Veterans Day. Have a great evening.
very much, ladies and gentlemen. Staff Sergeant Luke Brimhall on the trombone. Master Sergeant Graham Breelove on the trumpet. Staff Sergeant Dustin Mollick on the tenor. Let's do one more for you.
Have a great evening. Thank you.